Alabama is currently the home of one of the most closely watched Senate races in recent history, and it has heated up with even more star power in the past few days. The controversial Republican candidate, Roy Moore, has been fighting off allegations of sexual misconduct, and even though some of the sources turned out to be less than reliable, Moore has suffered some terrible attacks. President Trump's support of the Republican candidate has no doubt helped Moore's cause, considering the audience he's catering to. Even though any allegations of misconduct are very damaging, the American people are understanding more and more the number of lies coming to us through the media, and are more apartment to trust the person whom they know something about, like President Trump, over broadcasting company with an agenda. Never one to be outdone by the president, former President Obama also threw his support behind an Alabama. President Trump's support of Moore was so effective that Obama decided to try and put his political sway behind Jones, the Democratic candidate. CNN gleefully reports that Obama is not only officially endorsing Jones, but has even recorded a robocall demanding that Alabamans support Jones, and throwing a little shade at Moore in the process. Underscore former President Barack Obama is adding his voice to the Alabama Senate race, imploring voters to go to the polls Tuesday to reject the candidacy of Roy Moore as part of an aggressive effort by Democrats to try and counter President Donald Trump's full-throated endorsement of the controversial Republican candidate. Underscore this one serious, Obama says in the call. You can't sit it out. Underscore two Democratic officials familiar with the Alabama race tell CNN that Obama recorded the phone message in recent days, at the very time Trump stepped up his own involvement in the campaign with a recorded message. Obama does not mention Moore by name. Underscore Doug Jones is a fighter for equality, for progress, Obama says. Doug will be our champion for justice. So get out and vote, Alabama. Underscore Obama's message to voters, intended to specifically reach black voters whose turnout is critical for Democratic candidate Jones, comes on the eve of a special election that has drawn extraordinary national attention and divided the Republican Party over whether sexual allegations against Moore make him unfit for office. Where did Obama get the bright idea to jump in now? Why, from President Trump, of course. President Trump recently recorded a call that was sent out for Moore's campaign that said, in part, hi, this is President Donald Trump and I need Alabama to go vote for Roy Moore, Trump says in the call. We're already making America great again. I'm going to make America safer and stronger and better than ever before. But we need that seat. We need Roy voting for us. I am stopping illegal immigration and crime. We're building a stronger military and protecting the Second Amendment and our pro-life values. But if Alabama elects liberal Democrat Doug Jones, all of our progress will be stopped cold. Trump said Moore is the guy we need to pass our Make America Great Again agenda. Roy is a conservative who will help me steer this country back on track after 8 years of the Obama disaster, said the president. So why has President Trump's recording gone out, but Obama's hasn't? That's easy. The target audience loves Trump and doesn't love Obama. According to BizPak Review, while Jones, Moore's competition, needs all the help he can get, what he needs help with are the middle ground Republicans who don't love the stink that this controversy has left on Moore, and Obama isn't the way to distance oneself from a stink. As of Sunday night, the Jones campaign has yet to play the Obama card, for fear of alienating the one group they need to ultimately win, Republican-leaning white voters, according to the New York Times. Of course, that hasn't stopped the Jones campaign from fear-mongering, trying to drive its African-American base to the polls by running commercials declaring that Moore is backed by the racist alt-right groups and calling him a birther, still insisting that Barack Obama was born in Kenya and isn't an American. Republicans are between a rock and a hard place in Alabama. While Moore is accused of doing some pretty unsavory things 4 decades ago, in allegations that suspiciously only came to light after he defeated Luther Strange in the GOP primaries, it should be obvious what the pro-choice, anti-Second Amendment, Liberal Democrat Jones would do as he is given the reins of power. In other words, Alabamians need to decide whether what Moore may or may not have done four decades ago is worse than what people like Jones will do to them, and the rest of the country, right now. Alabama has the unenviable task of trying to sort fact from fiction in what is an unbridled media crap storm. There's no way that someone, maybe several Semyons, aren't lying to the good people of Alabama right now. President Trump, like many Americans, has found himself in the position of choosing to endorse the person who is likely to do the least damage, and in this case, that's Moore. H/T, BizPack Review, CNN, follow us on Facebook at Freedom Daily.